What's up, guys? Sim here, and this is No Prep News, episode number 61. And in the first time ever in the history of both No Prep News and Street Race Talk, we are having a part two to the previous week's episode. I don't know if I've ever done something like this before, where the week before the main topic, we followed up with the exact same main topic once again the following week. And you'll be thinking, well, why the heck are we doing that? Last week, you know, you talked about Big Chief's new car and him possibly coming out with it for this upcoming season of No Prep Kings. Well, so much more news has come out from people messaging me, the comments we got on last week's episode, in regards to this main topic. I'm like, you know what? Let's talk about it again. And starting off with just the sheer amount of comments we got on last week's episode, the previous top commented episode of No Prep News, I believe, had 160, maybe 170 comments in total. Last week's episode, in less than a week, got 315 comments. You guys went off on last week's episode with leaving comments. I'm like, you guys clearly want to talk about it, so let's talk about it once again for this week's episode. But before we get into that, there's a couple of things I need to address. First off, Gypsy Mike. I'm sure a lot of you have heard the deal with that, what happened with him. Rest in peace to Gypsy Mike. Thoughts and prayers going out to friends and family. Unfortunately, I haven't had an opportunity to vocally say it myself in a video. I've left comments and pinned comments in previous videos when it first happened and we first found out about it. So again, thoughts and prayers going out to friends and family. Just tragic to hear something like that. And again, thoughts and prayers going out to his friends and family. Now moving on over to some comments from last week's episode of No Prep News. Starting off with the first comment from John Castile. You said, I feel like some people just watch because of all the positivity you bring. And man, I'm scrolling through all the comments and everyone is leaving comments about, maybe some people were leaving comments about Kai Kelly. Some people were leaving comments about Big Chief. And then seeing that, I feel like some people just watch because of all the positivity bring. And just thank you so much for that, man. That means so much. And Jason and Lisa, when are you going to do the 405 to hang out with Sean Ellington? And now I actually have heard back from Phantom, and he said they're extremely busy right now. Once they get some free time, I will be trying to set something up with them. And man, I cannot wait for that. That video is going to be insane once it does end up happening. Then Bird606 left a comment saying they canceled Gas Monkey Garage. I hate to go out on a limb. I'll say Street Outlaws will be next. It will just be Memphis and No Prep Kings. Now, I have, in fact, heard that Fast and Loud is no more. I believe Richard Rawlings announced it on the Joe Rogan podcast because Joe Rogan brought it up. He was asking about the TV show Fast and Loud. And he said, yeah, it's actually done. I've parted ways with Discovery Channel. And I was shocked to hear that, to be completely honest, because I not only thought that maybe if Fast and Loud would stop, they would still use him for other stuff, but it seems like he's completely separated with Discovery Channel. Although, with your comment about Street Outlaws, I couldn't disagree more. I mean, I believe you're talking 405 in particular. The 405 are Street Outlaws. I've said this before. Big Chief is Street Outlaws. The 405 are Street Outlaws. They're not going to be going anywhere anytime soon. You even replied to someone else's comment on your comment saying, I'll Cash App bet $100 that it is canceled next year. I'd bet $2,000 that it's not, the 405 won't be gone within the next 2 years. I mean, the 405 isn't going anywhere anytime soon. Yes, we haven't seen them on TV recently, but I mean, look at everything that's going on right now. Just things just have unfortunately not really worked out. Although the 405 is coming back January 11th. January 11th is, I believe, the date of when we're going to be seeing the start of the new season of the 405 Styles. But yeah, Fast and Loud, unfortunately, is done. Some people might be leaving comments saying, it's not unfortunately they're done, it's finally gone. I enjoyed the show when it first started. I never really watched it anymore. But in regards to the 405 ever going away, yeah, there's going to be a long time until that happens. Then moving on over to the main topic, being a follow-up on last week's main topic, with that being Big Chief's new car, which he seems to be building. Now, like I said in last week's episode, all of this is 100% speculation, guesstimates, estimates, assumptions. None of this is fact set in stone in any way, shape, or form. Although we have had some clues that lead us to believe that, okay, pretty soon some of these assumptions might turn into facts being set in stone. Now, starting off with last week's main assumption that we made, and that was that that 78 Bandit Trans Am was in fact going to be Big Chief's new car. Now, you guys are leaving comments, and we'll start off with this comment right here from Christopher Duncan saying, I'm actually building this for a friend of mine, Steve Chechak, explained Lutz of the car's Pittsburgh-based owner. It's going to be a Smokey and the Bandit tribute car, but big tire style for a Hot Rod Drag Week's Unlimited Iron. A couple of other people left similar comments, and shout out to all those guys that were leaving those comments, and that makes sense. I mean, looking at the car, someone else left a comment saying it just like the chassis and like look at the rear end and stuff. It doesn't look like something we'd see on Street Outlaws. It doesn't look like that type of car. And I was saying, well, they posted about it so long ago. Why haven't we seen it since then? Clearly, it was built for Drag Week. Drag Week didn't happen this year, so where would we have seen it race? I mean, it does make sense that that is not actually Big Chief's car, thanks to all those that were leaving comments down below. Now, because that car doesn't seem to be a car being built for Big Chief, that does not mean he still isn't building another car. I still believe he's building another car. I just kind of put that together with that Trans Am because it was like, okay, some things were clicking here and there. Unfortunately, it looks like that is not going to be true. That Trans Am we discussed last week is not going to be Big Chief's new car. But I do believe he is still building a new car. We have a couple of other comments to follow up with that right here from Broken Planet 1974. You said, I talked to Jeff Lutz not long ago and asked him if he was building a new car for Chief. He personally told me Chief is indeed building a new car, but he is not the one building it. Now, again, we have no idea who would even build it. I saw a lot of people saying that they were guessing Don Dial would be the one building it because he's the one that worked on the chassis for the original Crow. But looking at the new Crow when they got it, if I'm not mistaken, they got like a start, but then Jeff Lutz was the one that essentially did the rest of the chassis, which we saw in Mega Race. Well, it was Mega Race 1, if I'm not mistaken, when they built the new Crow. So who's building it? I really don't know. All I know is that I'm assuming that I just have a hunch that it is being built. There's going to be a new car very soon. And now moving on over to the final comment from Ryan Wilson. Now I picked out your comment right here because you're the only one out of 315 comments that left a comment this particular about this subject. You said Chief had a Billet 876 Pontiac engine built. Now we know he got a new engine built by Butler Performance. Word came out a while ago and we discussed that once we first found out about that news. But I have yet to hear the exact cubic inch. You said 876? That's pretty big. Now I don't know if this is a fact or not, if this is the cubic inch of the engine Butler Performance built for Big Chief. With it being for No Prep Kings, we'd assume, I mean, I wouldn't deny it 100%, but it seems almost out of place because we look at what Big Chief's ran for so long, the small block, as we'll call it. I know there's no big block or small block for Pontiac, but he's referred to it as a small block, so that's what we will refer to it as right now. I don't see him making that big of a jump. I mean, that's almost double the cubic inches as he's been running since the very beginning, so I don't know if we'd see something like that. If you're right, and if you have some more information about that, please, you know, message me on Instagram at SammyCXYZ. Leave another comment in the comment section down below of this week's episode. But I don't know about that. Again, I picked out your comment, though, because no one else had said anything even remotely close to that. I'm like, hey, you might be onto something right there, so we got to mention it in this week's episode. But overall, I do believe that Big Chief is, in fact, still going to be building a new car for No Prep Kings for this upcoming season of No Prep Kings. As we know, he just posted this, I think it was the end of last week, he posted a video of the Crow getting back to his shop, and he had a whole makeover done to that thing. It looked beautiful in the video clip that he posted, although I still believe that he might have done that work to the Crow, get that thing ready for the streets, and there's still going to be another car in the near future. Now, we know that, unfortunately, that 78 Trans Am is not being built for Chief. It is, in fact, being built for someone to race in Hot Rod Drag Week, as we mentioned earlier in this episode. Although, I have another guess to what his new car might be. Now, I don't like just completely throwing stuff out there, just completely out of the blue, and just say something. I hate doing stuff like that. But I have seen so many people leave a comment with their own assumption or some evidence behind it to being what my guess is for his new car. Now, I have not had any concrete evidence or information in regards to this possibly being his new car. But I've seen so many people say it, I'm like, I mean, there's a chance, and that chance is that it could be a first-gen Pontiac Firebird. I've seen so many people saying that they heard he's getting one built, they heard he bought one, they heard that a rumor from someone that said he's building this car, he's looking to build this car. I've just seen so much stuff behind that. I'm like, at some point, I gotta mention it in my video because You guys are the fans, and that's what No Prep News is all about. Talking about what the fans want to talk about and hear about, and what you guys think and believe the most. And I have to agree with you guys. It would make sense. There's the other guy. Robin Roberts, if I'm not mistaken. He's got the blue Pontiac Firebird. That thing is insanely fast, and we see him race in No Prep Kings previously. And I believe he just won a No Prep actually recently that went on not that long ago. It might have been Reaper's No Prep that he actually won, if I'm not mistaken. I don't remember. I could be wrong about that, but I know he beat Larry Larson in the finals of his race. Now, is Big Chief going to be building one of those? I don't know. We really will just have to wait and see. But the thing is, I've seen so many people say that that is the car he will be building. I mean, at some point, I'm like, okay, I have to start agreeing with you guys because, that's all we really got right now. We know he's building a new car. We know he's got a new engine for the car, but it's like what the car is itself. I really don't know. Our best guess right now is that Big Chief's new car for No Prep Kings is going to be a first generation Pontiac Firebird. So that is all. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you all so much for watching to the very end of this video. TTVE. Hope you guys all had a great Christmas. I know I posted that new episode of Street Race Talk on Christmas Day, but in case you guys missed it, hope you all had a Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays. Spent some good time with some friends and family, and I appreciate all the positive feedback I've been getting on my videos lately. You guys have just been blowing my mind with all the positivity comments. It means so much, guys. I thank you all so much for watching all my videos and for leaving all these nice supportive comments on every single one of my videos. It truly means so much, and I hope you guys enjoyed this week's episode. I apologize, this week's episode, I mean, it wasn't like some new news, but the thing is, you guys almost doubled the record for you guys almost doubled the record for most comments on a episode of No Prep News. I hope you guys understand what I'm saying. Previous record was like 160. Last week's episode was 315. I mean, you guys just blew it out of the water. I'm like, we gotta talk about this again. It's a huge topic. Big Chief possibly building a new car. Some more news and information came out in regards to it. I was like, we gotta follow up with it again for this week's main topic. And I hope you guys enjoyed this week's episode. Make sure you guys tune in on Monday tomorrow for a new episode of Red Light Questions. Tuesday for a new episode of Door Shutters. Wednesday for a new random video on my channel. Possibly Friday for a new episode of Street Race Talk. Then next Sunday for another new episode of No Prep News. All the videos upload go live at 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. So make sure you guys click that little bell. Turn notifications on so you miss a single video upload. Again, more videos go live 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. And make sure to leave your thoughts and opinions in the comment section down below in regards to what you think Big Chief will be building for his new car. Do you agree and think that it will be a first-gen Pontiac Firebird? If not, what do you think it will be? Leave it all in the comment section down below. Top comments and some of my favorite comments from this week's episode will be read and discussed in next week's episode of No Prep News. Betsy shirts and hoodies also available at simsxyz.weebly.com or first link down below in the description. I also set up a P.O. box if you guys want to send me stuff. Address is down below in the description. Again, that is all. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure you guys follow me on Instagram at SimABCXYZ. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And this is SimABCXYZ signing out.